Thanks for joining me. In this video, I'll be discussing about the application process for official transcript from University of Calicut. There are two options. Option one, you have to go to the university with all the required documentation and apply directly. Option two is for those who are unable to go to the university. I'll be discussing further on option two.
So let's start the process. This is the official page of University of Calicut. Scroll down. You can see student support portal. Click it. You can see various options here. Now, since we are discussing on official transcript, you can click how to apply for official transcript. Here it's clearly mentioned on the procedure. So you can go through this, but I'll explain. First, you download the application. This is the application for official transcript. You can fill in all the details, name and address of the candidate in capital letters with PIN. Then mobile number, provide a mobile number which is reachable so that in case of any clarifications, they can reach you. You can mention the name of the course here. Then center of the exam, register number, provide all the numbers. Say if you have done BTEC from first semester to eighth semester, write down all the numbers including supplementary and improvement exams. In case the space is not sufficient, you can attach a sheet wherein you can mention all the numbers clearly right from first semester to eighth semester. And you can provide a reference here. Year of passing the exam, purpose of official transcript, mention the purpose, whether you need to send to a university or to WES, so whatever is the purpose you can clearly mention. Number of official transcript to be sent, you can mention here how many number you need. Address to which transcript is to be sent, so mention also all the address. If you need a personal copy, you can say yes, otherwise no. Here you have to fill the fee payment details. I will come back to this. You can go to the previous page. Just scroll down. You can see a link given here for the fee payment. So you can click instant pay. You can select the purpose. Transcript verification. This is the code. Then you can put your name, address, date of birth, mobile number, email, amount. The fee structure is given here clearly. So it all depend on number of mark list you have to, number of mark list. So say if you have 10 mark list for your course, including supplementary and improvement, say. So the fees will be 1655 into 10, which is 16,550. Then search fee, say if you passed your exam in 2020, so it is within 3 years, so 225 you can add to 16,550. Then postal charge, if this or official transcript has to be delivered to within India, so it will be 50 rupees. Otherwise, the postal charge has been given to various countries. Say Canada, it's 1392. So you sum up all this transcript fee, search fee, then postal charge. If it is to Canada, say 1392. So you sum up all this, and you can put the amount here, amount details here. Then save and continue. And once you get the receipt, you download and keep it. Take a print of the receipt. I will tell you the purpose of that. So you can pay it by credit card or debit card. So once you download that challan receipt, you can put the challan number here, amount, date, the place of remittance. And once you fill all these details, sign, place and date. Okay, one thing I want to tell you is ignore all these details here. This is not the correct data. they have revised all this, and you can see the details here. So this is the correct detail, okay? So just ignore this. This you can ignore. It's a very old application form. However, this is given in their official website. So this is the application form you have to download and fill. So once this is done, so once the fee payment is done, so you have everything now. So you take a copy of your mark list. I have seen people asking me whether we have to attach original mark list or copy. Well, we have to attach the copy of the mark list. Yeah, and for this degree certificate, if you need this degree certificate to be sent along with the mark list, then you have to again pay an additional 1655 rupees for the certificate, because for VES only they are asking for mark list. That's the reason I have said only mark list. If you want, if your institution asks for a degree certificate, you have to pay additional 1655. So just keep in mind. So attach your mark list. As I mentioned, the documents required are mark list of your degree course or PG, whatever, then application printout, which is this duly filled application printout, then challan receipt printout, which I mentioned. I mean, once you go here and take a print, then you can take a printout of that and attach here. Then all these documents. So along with that, this VES, they have a request form. And if you go to VES website, they have a academics record request form. You can download that also and attach with this. It is only applicable for VES who are doing like VES verification. For other institutions, you have to check with your respective institution how they, how the procedure is. So along with this, you can attach your 10 certificate copy and 12 certificate copy, because for the date of birth verification. So you can keep all these copies and you can send it by post to the to this address in India. So and I mean, one more thing I forgot to say, you can even make the payment through this Akshaya e-centers or Friends Janaseva Kendra and all. So there is a option here for the payment. Whoever wants to do the online payment, you can click this link, and as I mentioned, you can make the payment here. Otherwise, there is an option to even pay through these centers. So once you send it to the send it by postal, you can keep a track of the postal. So once you understand it has been received by the university, you can very well check with them. You can call them on their contact. This is the contact numbers been given. So I would say you have to frequently give a call, because maybe in a first try you may not get them, because it's a very, you understand, it's a university and it's very busy. And so keep on calling them, and once you get them, then you can talk to them and ask them about the status of your application. And I would suggest, from my experience, you can request them to provide a number of your department. Say if it is BTech, you can ask them to give the BTech department number, so that you can talk to them directly rather than calling the inquiry number. So once you get that number, you can ask about your application status. They'll be having the details of each and every person. Say they have received the application today, say, then they will say now how many days this will take for them to verify, say 1 month. So keep a track of that, and after 1 month you can follow up with them. And there is a you can raise a ticket. I mean, here if you go to this page, there is a link here, open a new ticket, wherein you can raise your ticket and ask your questions here, and you can even check the status of that. So they will respond to this tickets. So So once the transcript is ready from the university, they will be sending it via postal to the required destination, say BES, or you know, wherever you want the transcript to be sent. So this might delay the process, as the postal department might take 2 to 3 weeks. So to accelerate the process, you can request your university to send it online. If the university has got a tie-up with the institution, say WES, so Calicut University has got a tie-up with WES, so it can be sent online also. So you can request the university to send it online. So for that, you need to request the University of Calicut to send you an email ID, to provide an email ID, and you can send in your request to them to accelerate. So I believe we have covered all the topics required for the application process. In case if you have further doubts, you can put your questions in the comment box and I will reply accordingly. Thank you.